demonstrations, marches, rallies, speeches, and more speeches. Parties across Italy's political spectrum have pulled out all the stops in the lead up to a constitutional referendum, which on the surface might not seem to merit all this sound and fury. Italy's energetic 41-year-old Prime Minister Matteo Renzi is trying to convince a perennially skeptical people to modify Italy's constitution to slim down and defang its bloated Senate. The chance for real change, Renzi told this crowd in Rome, is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Sì o mai? Sì o mai? Deve essere chiaro questo. Non ci sarà una seconda occasione.
Yes or never, he says. This needs to be clear. There will not be another chance. Renzi promises a streamlined constitution will be a tonic for Italy's anemic economy, high unemployment, and mind-boggling bureaucracy. But if the latest polls are right and no wins, trouble might follow. After Brexit and Trump, could Italy be the next to shake the established order? There is worry that a no vote could lead to Italy's exit from the European Union, to a collapse of the country's already shaky financial house. But it's important to keep in mind that a no vote means nothing changes. Yes, it could lead to the collapse of the government of Prime Minister Renzi, but Italy has seen 65 governments since the end of World War II. Change here is, at best, glacial. The opposition to the constitutional changes ranges from the far left to the far right, all worried the changes would give too much power to Rome. Matteo Salvini, head of the anti-migrant Lega Nord, is driving around northern Italy in a camper, spreading the gospel of no. He takes inspiration from the U.S. president-elect. The lesson of Trump tells us we must have courage, he tells me. If the no vote wins, we'll present Italians with a revolutionary program. Soft-spoken former comedian Beppe Grillo, leader of the anti-establishment Euro-skeptic Five-Star Movement, Italy's second-largest party, has this advice for the many still undecided.
Fidatevi della vostra pancia.
Trust your gut, he says. Don't trust your brain. Whatever the result, Italy will muddle through, says commentator Massimo Franco.
Well, Italy will not finish at all after this referendum, whatever the outcome.
Grazie a tutti.
Lega Nord supporter Galileo has seen plenty of politicians promising the world and delivering nothing. Umpteen governments have left us up to our neck in muck, he says. Ben Wedeman, CNN, Camaiore, Italy.